Hello, I'm Park Jong-hyun. At the last session, we looked at the implant prosthesis features and also cases, as well as talked about how to understand implant prosthesis in part one. In part two, I'm going to talk about plan, process, and design about the implant prosthetic restoration. I try to include content that is of helpful to you, so let's get started. Top-down prosthetic plan. Some you might have heard about this, some might be hearing this for the first time. If you have attended many lectures in prosthetics, you probably are very familiar with such a concept. Now, top-down prosthetic plan, what it means is that the final prosthesis is planned from the beginning, and then abutment that fits to that plan is planned, and in the harmonious position of the abutment, fixture is planned and placed. So like now, if there is a buccal bone resorption, which is a common case, then if you deliver implant just considering the remaining bones, the prosthesis would have defect and restoration might be tricky. If you opt for top-down planning, then you will not only consider the bone conditions, but in the harmonious position to the final prosthesis, the fixture will be placed, and bone grafting will also be planned from the beginning. Let's look at the actual case. Due to splits a few years ago, endotoxic treatment and crown restoration was done at another dental clinic, but it can no longer be retained, and you also see bone resorption. In the place, the harmony with the final prosthetics, placing implant and if necessary doing bone grafting was planned from the beginning. If you use one guide of the OSTEM, the fixture can be placed in the position that you had planned from the beginning. So the fixture was placed in harmonious position to the prosthesis, and for the bone grafting, I perforated cortical bone. Xenografting and then membrane was also delivered, and transmucosal GBI was done. After osseointegration, as planned, the planned size abutment was connected, and as full zirconia, final prosthesis was done. After prosthesis was complete, I took X-ray. With the top-down prosthetic plan, if you do guided surgery, then as you can see, you can have a very predictable and harmonious results. Next, let's look at the prosthetic design. As I explained also in part one, but let me do it again because it's very important. For me, on the posterior side, as I explained in part one, I use mostly ER type. Interocclusal space, even if it's less than 5.5 millimeters, still, I opt for ER type prosthesis. Now, what I mean by that, let's look at further. If you want to do ER type, that subgingivally 3 to 4 millimeters of space, and for the prosthesis 3 to 4 millimeters of space, and also for the thickness of prosthesis, you need 1 2 millimeters of space. So from the top fixture to the if you have about 9 millimeters of space, then it's easy to do prosthesis. The ER type, if I may explain again, it's cement retained prosthesis, but it's also can be easily removed later on. So in the center of the crown, there is a screw hole. Let's look at a case. 4 millimeter of abutment is connected, then to the opposing teeth. For the thickness of prosthesis, 2 millimeter space can be secured. Then ER type prosthesis can be easily delivered to this space. Now, as you can look here, from the fixture top to the Kujo teeth, if you have about 9 mm space available, then it can be cement retained. And in the center, a screw hole in the cement type, if that is available, then I always opt for the ER type. In the past, I also used a few cases using the screw type. But more recently, as there is a different fixture placement direction for the multiple cases, then without the having misfit, it's impossible for placement. So in the multiple case, now I do not use screw types. Plus, after casting, the film can be formed, and in removing the film, the connection area, there is more likelihood for damage. So for restoration, if you lack into occlusal space, then in the past like this, I tried restore with screw type. Now, in case of ER type, even there is a misfit, such a difference with can be compensated with thickness of cement. But in screw type, if there is a misfit, the connection of the fixture abutment, it will be concentrated. So after some time, the bone reaction seems to be rather unstable. And after final prosthesis removed after 4 years, soft tissue is unstable. In the connection area, there's a uniform connection and only touches the top part. And as it arrow indicate, there is a tear. And conical seal is also unstable and resulting in contamination of the cotton inside. So the misfit, not through the connection, the cement can be compensated with the ER type, so I switch to that. If there's not enough space, then after making 1 foot abutment groove box sandblasting, and it's possible casting is very detailed, and through the such a process, it can be maintained for 7 years very stably. If it has passed 7 years with the screw type, I didn't think such result would have been available. So even if there's not enough space, if it's posterior, fixture abutment connection can be retained stably, and also as it can be removed easily later on, I tried to opt for ER type. Now let's look at the types of prosthetic materials. For me, when doing posterior restoration, if there is insurance available, PFM, if insurance not available, I often use zirconia. So whatever material you take, it's desired to have 1.5 to 2 millimeters of space. But if the space is not sufficient, then gold or metal is what I opt for. Now, interocclusal space is insufficient, so the minimum, the thickness can be maintained with metal, so I opt for that. So gold and metal, if they are used, it's more favorable in case there is not sufficient interocclusal space. So this case was really tricky one. To the tear of the opposing teeth, there's not much of extrusion, but because of tear, I could not prep the area, and the interocclusal space was also very insufficient. So to extend the tension, the abutment was subgingivally placed, then because that is the way to make it more secure. And also, to increase tension of the abutment, groove and box was formed, and the abutment retention area, I sandblasted. Is ER type, restoration was complete. 39 months later. So prosthesis space is not sufficient, but using gold, I was able to have a favorable result. In case insurance is available, the PFM metal is what I use, so I always go with PFM. As you can see, if it's upper part, to avoid porcelain fracture, I prefer using metal occlusion. However, if it's lower part, it's a different story. On the upper part, even with metal occlusion, aesthetically, it's no problem. But if it's mandibular side, if you opt for metal occlusion, it becomes too visible. So PFM, using porcelain, becomes less attractive. So on the buccal side, porcelain was used, and if PFM was used, and the occlusal face is the most visible area, and it looks less aesthetic. So recently, for secure uniform thickness, and if there is a sufficient support, as the porcelain fracture can be reduced, I opt for this type of design. Let me explain further. PFM crown screw hole around it, the metal treatment, and PFM crown outskirts was treated also with metal. I prefer this type of approach. And if you use this, there was one case that was, there was a fracture, but that's because I designed wrong. If there is a solid metal support, you will not have fracture on your hand. Using metalling, minimize porcelain fracture is what I opt for. It's not very aesthetic, but still more aesthetic than the metal occlusion, and it was more, a bit more free from any fracture. So if there is a space sufficient, then and it's not insured, then I opt for zirconia. So the top-down planning, I hope you were able to understand more through this lecture. You plan for the prosthetic, select the abutment, and place fixture in the area that is in harmony. It's very easy step, and I believe in that process, one guide system is very helpful. They say action before words. So if you hesitate, you cannot get things done. So you need to take action. But if you take action without any plans, you just end up being reckless. Same with the prosthetics. For the successful result and to have aesthetic result, you need to have a good plan and thorough plan in your on your hands. Rather than words, through thorough planning and taking action, I hope you can have good result both for your patient and for yourself. Thank you for your attention.